Welcome back to the Suburban Ford 7 Sportscave. My pleasure to bring in on the phone, straight from the airport in Atlanta, Drew Valentine, the assistant coach for the Loyola Ramblers, headed to the Final Four, Drew. I know we talked to you last week and you guys were riding high, getting to the Sweet 16. Has anything changed? Do you feel any different now that you're headed to the Final Four?
I mean, everything's changed. I mean, it's incredible. I mean, just the way that these guys have just managed to continue to just play and embrace this process and live in the moment, and our staff, it's just been an incredible journey for me, and I'm just so excited to be a part of this.
The NCAA tournament, obviously, it's about who's next now. You're going to take on John Beilein in Michigan. From a coaching perspective, I guess, what do you see with this team, and have you had a chance to really watch them, you know, a little bit?
Well, we haven't started breaking them down like that yet. But, I mean, Saadi Washington and DeAndre Haynes, two of their assistants, obviously Saadi coached me at Oakland, and he's one of my best friends. I talk to him almost every day, and DeAndre Haynes I talk to all the time as well. And so I'm always watching those guys and sending them texts and supporting them. So I guess this is going to be a little different for me having to go up against them. But I know they're a super talented team, and they're playing well at the right time.
Drew, I got to ask you this. Obviously, I'd be remiss if I didn't ask this. Sister Jean has been such a huge storyline, and I know obviously you guys all love her. She does seem like a fantastic lady, obviously. But there's been a lot of people saying kind of nationwide that, hey, all this over-the-top coverage of Sister Jean has kind of taken away the spotlight of the players and the coaches. Is there any part of you that thinks, hey, maybe that's a little... it's been a little excessive, or you kind of wish that these players are getting a little more credit, because they certainly deserve it?
Well, to be honest with you guys, I haven't had time to really like watch TV like that. Like, we've been so locked in on our scouting, so I haven't even really been able to watch many other games or watch much of TV coverage. But you know, whatever the situation is, or whatever the national media wants to in the story, it doesn't matter, because the guys are going to be out there that are going to be receiving the benefits at the end of the day. So she's an awesome storyline for us, and we couldn't be happier to have her. She's been so loyal and so great to our guys, and such a great ambassador for our university.
Drew, real quick, we'll get you out of here on this one. You're headed to the Final Four. You have all week to prep for Michigan and whatnot. What's your one thing? Now, you've been in coaching circles and stuff to see Michigan State get there and stuff. What have you picked up, and what will you make sure your guys know going into this? Because this is the biggest spotlight they'll ever play in, and they just played in some pretty big spotlights.
For sure. I just think we just got to keep doing what we're doing. I mean, we've prepared at an extremely detailed and complete level all year. So we're just going to continue to do that, and we're just going to keep, not talking about. We haven't talked about we have to win this, or seniors, this will be your last game, or we haven't talked about anything. Like, our motto all year has been the process and no finish line. The process leads to no finish line, and we're just going to continue with that, and that's kind of what I've learned from being around. I was with Michigan State. We made a 2015 Final Four run, and that's kind of what we did then, and so we're just going to try to continue to do that here.
All right, Drew. Hey, safe travels on your way back to Chicago. We appreciate it. And hopefully we'll be talking to you again next Sunday as you prepare for a championship game. How about that, bud?
For sure, man. Thanks for having me on, guys.
Appreciate it.
Thanks, Coach.
Take care.